Welcome back to the channel. Today I've got an idea which I think you're going to love. I've designed a PowerPoint slide. It's a TV remote which you press the buttons, it's going to change the TV in front of you. It's a concept that you can change to make your own designs. Right at the end of the video, I've shown you a few other ideas to come up with using the same concept. First thing you need to do is get the images involved, and you need to remove the background for the TV remote. So click on remove background, and there'll be a section where it says remove, mark areas to keep and mark areas to remove. The pink arrow is going to be the bit that it's deleted, so just draw around the bits that you want. Now the next thing is you need to include the videos. You should already be on your computer, so just import them and reshape them to the size of the TV. And also, you've now got these layers. You want to make sure the TV remote is on the top of the layers by clicking on Selection Pane. And you also want to rename all of your pictures and all of your videos, because it makes it easier later when you're animating them. So give your videos a number, which is going to correspond later to the buttons you're going to be pressing later. Now let's make the buttons. They can be an auto shape and make them whatever shape you want, and overlay them on top of the buttons that you want to press on the TV remote. So I've got three buttons, putting them on the buttons 1, 2, and 3, and I'm also going to format them so that those buttons are semi-transparent. You don't want to be able to see them, or maybe just a little bit. You want to maybe just about see the outline of them, so that it's easier to know where to click when you're in the presentation. So the next thing you want to do when you've done all that is to animate the presentation. So the first thing you need to do is click on the video, click on animate, and click on appear. You want it to appear first, because otherwise they'll always be appeared at the same time, so you won't be able to see what's going on. First of all, click on appear, and then click on effect options, and then go on to triggers. So go timing, triggers, and now you just choose the button that you've already named. So choose button 1. Okay, and now you want another animation on top of that. So click on add animation and click on play, and that will happen at the same time. So you drag that animation down into the trigger section, and that will happen at the same time as the video appears. So now you just need to do that quite easily to the other two videos. You want them to appear, and then you want them to play. And you also want them to do them on the trigger of a different button. So trigger 2, and the other thing you need to do is make sure that that second animation happens with previous. So click on it and then go on to, instead of on click, you want it to happen with previous. Okay, so now you need to do it with the third video, same sequence. And this is what it should look like at the end. You've got this animation pane, and you've got trigger 1, trigger 2, trigger 3. They all appear and then they all play depending on which button you've clicked. So pretty simple so far, but you also need all those videos to disappear when the other one appears, otherwise you're going to have a mess. So for each animation or each video, you want disappear, which goes in each trigger section. So for example, press button 1, video 2, video 3 should disappear, and video 1 should appear and play. So that's what you should have in your animation pane, and that's what I'm doing at the moment. So you can see lots of animations in each trigger button. And the top has a click, so that means you click it, and then the others are with previous. If you don't click with previous, it's not gonna work. The animation won't work. Okay, so now that's everything, that should work. So now you wanna go on the presentation slide, and you wanna click on from beginning, and this is what it should look like. You've got the button, and you've got the TV remote, and you've got the video already playing. You click on a different button, and this is what should happen. Here we go. So now we're on my flight simulator video, another PowerPoint animation video that I made. So check my channel if you want to make this. And here's a drawing animation, video scribe animation that which I made. Have a look on my YouTube channel if you want to have a look. So I've got one other idea for the same concept, which is a flight simulator where you click on the buttons and you go to a different planet, great for teachers, but there's lots of other ideas. Please let me know what your ideas are. Put it in the comments below. And check back next week because I have another tutorial working on the same lines. So this tutorial I've made a little bit quicker than some of my others. So let me know in the comments if it's too fast. I will try and make it a bit easier in the future. Thanks very much. Bye.